There is no question of enmity, no rivalry, no intolerance, no fighting, no battle, nothing. Why? Huh? This is the only reason. Those who have developed such mentality of lording it over and enjoying, they are demons. You understand? They are demons. They are demons. And one who has such desire, insatiable desire for enjoyment. His desire is so insatiable. In ninth canto, you'll find Yayati Maharaj says, Jat prithivyam brihi javam hiranyam pasavastriya. Na duhyanti mana pritiṃ punsa kāma hatasyate. Those are very lusty persons, greedy persons. Do you understand? Very lusty, very greedy. If they will get all the wheat, rice, barley, all the corns of the whole world, if they will get all the metals, all silver, all gold, all copper, the whole world, if they will get all the beasts, birds, animals of the whole world, if they will get all the women of the whole world, still they will not be satisfied. No, will be satisfied, he says. No, duhyanti manapriti punsa kama hatasyati. Jat prithivyam brihi javam hiranyam pasavastriya. No duhyanti manapritiṃ punsa kāma hatasyate. You understand? They will never be satisfied. Their desire for enjoyment will never be satiated. Unsatiable, isn't it? Chidananda, if Chidananda will get everything, still unsatiable. No, more. Then he says, no dātu kāma kāmānam bhūgena samyati habisā kusumvatni bhūyo. If you pour ghee into blazing fire, it will never extinguish. It becomes more ablaze and say, give more ghee. Never becomes this extinguished. Similarly, more you give enjoyment to your senses, more they demand. Give more. Why one wife? 100 wives, 1,000 wives, let me enjoy. Isn't it? This Yayati says, Yayati Maharaj says, gives his own experience, go on. Because Yayati was cursed by his father-in-law, Sukracharya. You understand? Yayati married the daughter of Sukracharya, Devajani. You understand? But one dasi, she had one dasi, Sarmistha. Sarmistha. You understand? So, Yayati fell in love with Sarmistha. So that is intolerance. Woman's nature. Oh, my husband fell in love with that Sarmistha, my maid servant. So she told her father, Sukracharya, you see. Then Sukracharya has cursed Yayati. You become impotent, you become old, you become invalid, finish. No enjoyment, you cannot enjoy. Impotent, old, invalid, Yayati became. So, Then his wife thought, oh, my husband became important, my husband became old, my husband became invalid. How can I enjoy? Who will give me enjoyment? So I am, indirectly, I am bereft of enjoyment now. Then she again pleaded, oh, my father, I am now bereft of enjoyment. My husband became invalid, old and important. Then father said, affectionate father, yes, now daughter says this thing. All right, this can be exchanged. If someone can mercifully take his invalidity, do you understand? Old age, everything, and give his youth to him, then he will enjoy. This question of exchange comes. At that time, Yayati had, do you understand, young sons, they are all young. He requested, you, oh my boy, will you please take away my invalidity, my old age, give your youth, then I will enjoy. Huh? You understand? Who will give? Oh, though his father all denied, no. Why take your invalid old age and we become, will be bereft of enjoyment. Nobody wants this thing. So his youngest son, Puru, gave him, all right, father, I'll give him. You take my youth, I'll accept yours.